The desire to discover new worlds has taken humans deep into outer space. But planet Earth still holds its own secrets, with much left to be discovered in its liquid depths.
The ocean covers 75% of the Earth. We don't know much about them.
We know about the surface of the Moon and Mars better than we know about the actual seafloor.
In Florida, reports of large gatherings of fish in the Gulf of Mexico piqued the interest of divers. They discovered an unlikely find beneath the fish. Deep, dark holes opening down into the seafloor.
You're swimming along on the bottom and it's very sandy. You'll see some fish go by, some random organisms around, but then you approach these holes and all of a sudden it's just booming with life.
These openings, commonly called blue holes, vary in size and depth. Some have only a small entrance that's 5 feet wide and opens up into a large room, while others extend down over 400 feet into the earth.
But the allure is, well, you wonder what's a little deeper and a little deeper. But pretty soon you're 150 feet or so and there's more to see. So you want to go deeper and deeper and find out what's going on.
These environments are so understudied that we don't even have the basic information to just characterize them.
Now, multiple institutions and volunteer technical divers are teaming up for expeditions to explore these environments like never before.
It's definitely exotic. The ability to really get in these systems and make human observations, which is really important, is pretty analogous to a space exploration.
Nobody's taken measurements. Nobody's looked at the fauna. Nobody's looked at the geology or where they float. It's all exploration.
We're interested in whether or not these holes are connected to mainland Florida. Is there any connection through the groundwater system? Is any of the fresh water getting out to these holes? If they are a source of nutrients, which could potentially be a possible source of nutrients for red tide, we don't know.
Why are these deep holes in the seafloor? And what makes them vibrant oases in an ocean desert?